Hello everyone. In this video, we're going to be talking about monitors. Now, a monitor is the primary output component of a computer. On a desktop computer, it connects to the computer's video card through a monitor cable, and it displays images on the screen. A computer monitor may have one or several video ports that monitor cables plug into, and those ports and cables could be VGA, DVI, HDMI, or DisplayPort. And some modern monitors may include USB-C and Thunderbolt ports. So if you're in the market for getting a new monitor, you need to make sure that you get one with the correct video port to match your video card, because otherwise you'll end up using adapters or exchanging the monitor. Now, an older type of monitor is called CRT, which stands for cathode ray tube, which was a technology first used in television sets. These monitors are bulky and very heavy, and they take up a lot of space, and they are no longer existent in the marketplace today. An image is produced on a CRT by using three color electron guns. These colors are red, blue, and green, which when you combine them, they can produce any color on the color spectrum. These guns shoot beams of electrons on the screen and create an image that we see. These beams repeatedly sweep across the face of the monitor many times per second, so it's constantly redrawing the image that we see on the screen. And this redrawing of the image is known as the refresh rate. The refresh rate is measured in hertz. So for example, if the refresh rate is 60 hertz, then that means that the beams sweep across the entire face of the monitor, redrawing the image at a rate of 60 times per second. Today, some higher-end LCD monitors, which we'll talk about next, may have refresh rates as high as 240 Hz. Having a higher refresh rate reduces eye discomfort. It'll also reduce motion blur, and it will give you a smoother visual experience. Another type of monitor which has succeeded the CRT is the LCD. LCD stands for liquid crystal display. These monitors are lighter, thinner, use less power, and take up less space than CRTs. LCDs are also known as flat panel displays. LCD monitors produce an image on a flat surface by using liquid crystals. A backlight shines through these crystals to produce an image on the screen, and it uses filters to produce the different colors. LCDs were first used in laptop computers, and now it's the primary type of monitor that's used today for desktops. In order for LCD monitors to show an image on the screen, it needs to have a light source. And there are a couple of different types of backlighting that an LCD monitor uses. The older type of lighting is by using fluorescent lamps. These fluorescent lamps are the circular, glass, straight tubing types similar to regular fluorescent lamps that we're all used to seeing. These lamps emit ultraviolet light that's created when the mercury vapor inside the lamp is ionized. Another type of backlighting that LCD monitors use is LED. LED monitors use multiple light-emitting diodes that are arranged in a pattern that displays the images on the screen. Now, this is a modern form of backlighting compared to the older fluorescent lamp backlighting. The advantages that LED monitors have over the standard LCD is that it can produce sharper and more accurate colors. Another advantage is that it has a higher contrast ratio. The contrast ratio refers to the contrast between black and white. The higher the contrast ratio that a monitor has, the better, because it can produce a brighter white and a darker black. So for example, if a monitor has a contrast ratio of 1000 to 1, that means that the whites are 1000 times brighter than the blacks. LED monitors also consume less power, and it can also be made with a thinner form factor. Now, both of these monitors are considered LCD monitors, but the LCD that uses LED backlighting is considered an LED monitor. So, an LED monitor is just an LCD monitor that uses LED backlighting. Now, LCD or LED monitors will have three different types of flat panels. These types are TN, VA, and IPS. And these will vary in performance, color reproduction, and price. So the first one is TN. Now TN stands for twisted pneumatic. This type of flat panel works by liquid crystals actually twisting the light as it comes through. TN is the oldest of the three, which makes it the most affordable. But at the same time, it's also the best as far as performance, because it will have the highest refresh rates and the fastest response time, which makes it ideal for gaming. The response time is the time in milliseconds that it takes for a monitor to change from one color to another. For example, from black to white. A very fast response time would be 1 millisecond, as compared to a slower response time of 10 milliseconds. When a monitor has a fast response time, it helps eliminate monitor ghosting. Ghosting is when an image on a monitor leaves a trail behind it as it moves across the screen. And since TN monitors are the fastest, they are the best at eliminating ghosting when compared to other monitors. However, TN monitors do have some drawbacks, and one of those drawbacks is color reproduction, which are not as good as other types. And another drawback is poor viewing angles, especially when viewing vertically. A newer and more modern type of flat panel is IPS. And IPS stands for in-plane switching. IPS was developed because of the limitations of TN monitors. This type of monitor works by, instead of the liquid crystals twisting, like in a TN monitor, the liquid crystals in an IPS monitor will stay in place and are aligned in parallel with the glass. And because of this, an IPS monitor will have a better and more accurate color reproduction, and it will also have a better viewing angle than a TN monitor. So if you were to view a TN and an IPS monitor on a vertical angle, the IPS monitor would look relatively the same with very little change. But on a TN monitor, the image will dramatically change. So as you can see on a TN monitor, the colors get washed out. But the disadvantages of IPS monitors is that they are more expensive. They will have a lower refresh rate, and they will also have a slower response time compared to TN monitors. Now, a VA or vertical alignment monitor is sort of in the middle. VA monitors will have a refresh rate and response time faster than an IPS monitor, but slower than a TN. And it'll also have a better color reproduction than a TN monitor, but not as good as an IPS. So a VA monitor is basically a mixture of a TN and an IPS. So which flat panel type is the best? Well, that question depends on your specific needs. So if your profession is in graphics and photography, then you're going to want the best for color reproduction and accuracy. Therefore, you should go with an IPS monitor. Or if you're a gamer, you need a high-performance monitor with the highest refresh rates and the lowest response time. Then, in this case, you should go with a TN monitor. Or, if you want something that's sort of in the middle, then you might consider a VA monitor. And another type of monitor is OLED, which stands for Organic Light-Emitting Diode. OLED is used on monitors, modern smartphones, and high-end TVs. The biggest difference between OLED and LCD is the light source. So as I stated before, LCD monitors will use fluorescent bulbs or LEDs for backlighting. But OLED monitors are different. With OLED, each pixel will produce its own illumination without having a separate backlight. Electrical current is applied to organic compounds that cause them to glow. OLED monitors are relatively new in the marketplace, so they are more expensive. They produce great colors, including the darkest black color available today with the highest contrast ratio. A standard LED may have a contrast ratio of 1,000 to 1, but an OLED will have a contrast ratio of 100,000 to 1. And unlike LCD monitors, which use filters to produce colors, OLED produces their own colors without using filters, which is why they are even thinner than LED monitors. OLED monitors will also have the best viewing angles. So previously we compared a viewing angle between two LED monitors, which was an IPS and a TN monitor. and the viewing angle on the IPS monitor was clearly better. But if we compare an IPS with an OLED, the OLED comes out the winner. So as you can see, there is no loss in the colors when viewing an OLED on a vertical or horizontal viewing angle. The image is identical. Another thing to know about monitors is resolution. Resolution is defined as the number of pixels that are being used to display an image. A pixel is the smallest element in an image, and the higher the resolution, the higher the number of pixels will be used, which means a clearer and sharper image, and monitors come in different maximum resolutions. So for example, if a monitor has a maximum resolution of 1280 by 720, which is called HD or high definition, then that means that there are 1280 horizontal pixels by 720 vertical pixels, which means that there are over 921,000 pixels that are being used. If a monitor has a maximum resolution of 1920 by 1080, which is known as FHD or full high definition, this resolution will use over 2 million pixels. And if a monitor has a maximum resolution of 2560 by 1440, which is known as QHD or quad high definition, then this means that there are over 3.6 million pixels that are being used. This resolution is also known as 2K. And then there's 4K, which is also known as UHD or ultra high definition. And this will have a resolution of 3840 by 2160, which means that over 8 million pixels will be used. And then finally, there is the aspect ratio. The aspect ratio of a monitor is the ratio between the width and the height of the monitor. Today, the standard aspect ratio is called widescreen, which has an aspect ratio of 16 by 9. The 16 refers to the width, and the 9 refers to the height, which means that, for example, if a monitor happens to be 16 pixels wide, the height would be 9 pixels. Now, before the widescreen ratio of 16 by 9, there was the standard ratio of 4 by 3, which was more of a square shape, and this was used by CRT monitors and older LCDs. Today, there are even wider aspect ratios than widescreen, such as the ultra-wide, which has a ratio of 21 by 9. And even wider than that, there's the super-wide, which has an aspect ratio of 32 by 9. So guys, if you want to know which monitor that I personally use, I'll put a link below in the description of this video. I bought it 3 years ago and I've been using it ever since. It's a TN monitor, so it's a high performance monitor, so it's very fast, and it has to be because I use it to record and make these videos. So I highly recommend it. And once again, I'll put a link below. So I want to thank everyone for watching this video on monitors. Please subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and thank you for watching.